This video training is designed to help patients who cannot attend the face-to-face classes that are offered by Presbyterian Outpatient Rehabilitation Services. If you have further questions after viewing this video and reading the booklet, please contact your surgeon's office.
My name is David Scussell, and I'm a physical therapist here at Presbyterian Hospital. Today, I'm going to be going over with you exercises to help facilitate your recovery following your joint replacement surgery.
Your involvement is essential during recovery. Doing the exercises and getting back to everyday activities as directed by your doctor and therapists will make a big difference in your outcome and will help to prevent complications. We will guide you through this process. In this training, we will cover getting ready for knee replacement, what to expect at the hospital, after surgery and recovery, and discharge planning. Our physical therapists will demonstrate how to move and not to move after surgery. We will also demonstrate necessary exercises that you will need to do following the surgery. Before your surgery, it's important to read all instructions and make sure that your medical clearances are scheduled on time. Make a list of your medications, allergies, and basic health history for your surgeon and the nurses at the pre-anesthesia surgical screening, or PASS. They will update your Presbyterian medical record with information you provide. They will also tell you which medications to hold. You will also need to take time off of work. Most surgeons recommend 6 weeks, and most surgeons recommend that you do not drive for 4 to 6 weeks. Start planning your transportation assistance accordingly. Your surgeon will be directing you to get medically cleared for surgery. Be sure to read and follow all instructions from your surgeons. Many doctors have provided a checklist for this purpose. Plan on having all of your pre-op clearances completed 2 weeks before your surgery. Some common clearances may include primary care clearance, lab work, an electrocardiogram, or EKG, and a chest x-ray. Pre-anesthesia and surgical screening, or PASS, ensures that you are ready for surgery. This visit is arranged by your surgeon, and they will direct you there. The visit is usually 60 to 90 minutes. Additional time may be needed if you require further tests. Bring the following items to your PASS appointment: an updated list of all current medications, including vitamins, supplements, and over-the-counter medications; your insurance card; and a picture ID. Also note that fasting is not required for your PASS visit. At the PASS visit, nurses will review your health history and allergies, verify your medications, discuss anesthesia options, answer questions, and consult directly with an anesthesiologist if necessary. They'll screen for MRSA with a nasal swab. The results will be sent to the surgeon. If treatment is necessary, the surgeon's office will contact you. Screen for COVID-19 and set you up for testing if needed. Give instructions and soap for pre-surgery showering. And discuss pneumonia prevention. An important type of medication that is held are NSAIDs. NSAID stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Common NSAIDs include ibuprofen and naproxen. Stop taking NSAIDs 7 days prior to your surgery. Before your surgery, take a look around your home and think about how you will get around. Make sure you have enough room to access necessary areas, including your bedroom, bathroom, living area, and kitchen, safely with a walker. For the first few weeks at home, your knee will be stiff and sore. It may be difficult to put weight on it or bend it. You'll need an armchair that is easy to get in and out of. You may need equipment for toileting, bathing, or sitting. What you will need depends on your home, your strength, and your size. The usual length of stay for a total knee replacement is 12 to 24 hours. However, this varies based on your doctor's preference and your recovery. While you are in the hospital, we will make every effort to make you comfortable and progress your activities. You will receive nursing care, physical therapy, and occupational therapy as ordered by your surgeon. Visiting hours vary with department and hospital policies. You are not assigned a room until after the surgery, so please leave your belongings with a family member or friend if possible. You will not be in the hospital very long, so there's no need to bring a lot of clothing. Some recommended items to bring include a cellular phone and long charging cable, loose-fitting clothing, shoes that you plan to wear after, glasses, dentures, and/or hearing aids, a CPAP machine if you use one. Please leave valuables at home. Your check-in time is arranged by the surgeon. These day of surgery times are estimated. Ask your surgeon for more details. It's possible for the time of your surgery to change, so be available by phone the few days before surgery in the event your surgeon does have a change. Pain medicine is given according to doctor's orders and is managed by the nursing staff. Your pain will be managed throughout your hospital stay. In most cases, oral pain medicine is used. For more information about pain medication choices, contact your doctor. Use laxatives as needed, but there's no need to use them preventively. At the PASS appointment prior to surgery, the nurses will give you tips on how to prevent postoperative pneumonia. Please read this information before surgery. Getting out of bed and moving helps to prevent pneumonia too. Adequate pain control helps with that. Just as important to prevent pneumonia, early and frequent walking helps prevent blood clots too. Physical therapy will try to get you up to walk on the day of your surgery. If you're not ready, you will sit up at the edge of the bed. Compression stockings, also called TED hose, will be provided by the nurses. Usually they're worn during the day for 28 days or as directed by your surgeon. You should take them off at night. Your surgeon will also order anticoagulants after the surgery. Take them as directed. Ask your doctor if and when you can resume taking NSAIDs. Physical therapists are very important members of your team after a total knee replacement. They will be visiting you and making sure you are moving safely and progressing towards the goal of getting back to your regular activities. If needed, your physician may ask an occupational therapist to consult with you. Expect to either work with physical therapy or sit up and stand with nursing on the day of your surgery, depending on the timing of your surgery and arrival on the nursing unit. Your physical therapist will instruct you on exercises to regain the motion and strength in your knee, and will work with you to ensure that you're able to get up and walk safely before you return home. These exercises can be found in your total knee book. It's important to begin them now as your pain allows, so that they are familiar to you after surgery. The goal of these exercises is to improve the motion and strength in your knee, as well as reducing swelling after surgery. Do these exercises regularly as instructed by your therapist.
Today, I'm going to be demonstrating for you four exercises that are located in your booklet. The first one is called ankle pumps. It's very easy. It's to prevent blood clots. Ankle pumps are literally just pumping your foot up and down. You can do this seated, you can do it laying down, and you can also do it standing, almost like you're looking impatient, tapping your foot. The next exercise I'll be demonstrating for you are glute sets. Glute sets are very important in order to re-engage your gluteal muscles in order to ease walking, balance, and walking up steps. In order to do a glute set, all you do is squeeze your bottom together and then relax and back again. A 3 to 5 second hold is just fine. The next exercise I'm going to demonstrate for you is called quad sets. I'm going to lay down for this exercise. When you're doing this exercise, your goal is to tighten your top thigh muscle, your quadricep muscle, as hard as you can, trying to push your knee back into the bed that you're lying on to engage it. A 3 to 5 second hold is good. 10 repetitions is good too. One of the most important exercises that you're going to need to do following your total knee replacement is called the towel prop. You just take a towel and put it underneath your ankle and let gravity take your knee and make it straight for you. This can be very uncomfortable, but you're going to need to push through it to achieve full extension of your knee to allow ease with walking. First, I'm going to sit down. Then I'm going to use my non-operated leg to help lift my operated leg. I cross my non-operated leg underneath my operated leg. Now when I turn over, I can lift using this leg to help my operated leg into bed. Same thing when I come out of bed. Sleeping on your back is recommended. However, if you are unable to sleep on your back, your PT or OT in the hospital can show you how to sleep on your side safely. Next, we want to cover safe transfers in and out of a chair. First, you're going to reach back for the chair, the object that you're going to sit on, and lower yourself down nice and slow. When you get back out of the chair, you want to take your operated leg and make it straight in front of you. Next, you're going to take your hands and push up out of the chair, then reach for your walker and bring your leg back safely underneath you. There is another way to do it. When you come up out of the chair, you can reach one hand for your walker and one hand on the hard object that you're going to push against to bring yourself up safely. What we don't want you to do is to reach with both hands towards the walker and try to push yourself up this way. It makes it unsafe. The walker could potentially fall back on you.
If you do not have a walker, one will be ordered after your surgery. Ask your insurance company about coverage for a walker. We will be teaching you about proper walking techniques in the hospital.
While in the hospital after your surgery, your physical therapist or your occupational therapist will go over about how to properly size your walker for your height. To properly size your walker for your height, you want to take the little wrist bone right above your thumb, and you can put it right up against the handle of your walker. That's a perfect size fit for you. That gives you approximately 30 degrees bend in your elbow, so then you can push yourself up if you need to. And so then the walker is not too high, where now my shoulders are up in my ears. Many people following a total joint surgery on their leg tend to be tentative when they're walking. We want to advocate for you walking heel toe. The reason for that is we want you to fully bear weight through that leg so that then that joint can take hold.
The goal is for you to be able to go directly home after surgery. In order to make this happen, you'll need to be prepared to have help at home, home safety equipment, and transportation to and from appointments. If this plan has to change for some unexpected reason, you, your surgeon, care team, and insurance will collaborate to determine the next best and safest option. You and your surgeon or physician assistant should talk about your discharge needs before surgery. Thank you for learning about your surgery. For more questions, please contact your surgeon's office.